rough day with Druids. These are obviously the two teams that you expect to play Resto Druid, but now you look at Mauro, and he's going to be on the Boomkin right now as well. Let's see what it can do for Wildcard Gaming.
There have been a lot of changes to Boomkin, and they've really lost their Boom. They bring like good defense with Bear Form, but other than that, Cyclone is very expensive now. It's difficult to get crowd control. We do see good pressure initiated by Zpy at the moment towards Raikou with that Lightning Lasso. Raikou jumping over to Looney, trying to switch targets. Pressure is there, but as soon as Raikou starts attacking, that Leech healing is going to start stabilizing his health. Mauro and Looney both trading a lot of defensive cooldowns early on in this initial exchange. Perhaps the Balanced Druid could work for Mauro here, but I'm not sold.
Yep, and both Method Black and Method Orange in North America have been using this composition, the Demon Hunter Death Knight comp. And the reason why it's so strong right now is both the Demon Hunter and the Death Knight provide so much self-healing to themselves that Chaz is not going to have to use as much mana to keep them alive. Raikou getting bursted down, and we're going to be looking for these Lightning Lassos coming in from Zpy. It's a channeled stun that does percentage-based damage, so if Zpy can channel that entire Lightning Lasso on a target, it will do significant damage, and Raikou and Swaps are going to have to be careful for that.
All right, Chaz deflects this incarnation of Mauro perfectly. No real openings found here for Wildcard Gaming just yet before dampening. Definitely of utmost importance that these Restoration Druids look for resets and try to regenerate mana by drinking for late game plays, as it is likely that dampening will be needed here in this specific matchup. Raikou getting taken down a bit, but immediately stabilized by Chaz. Swapsy and Raikou just running down Mauro, and the main reason why you want to target a Balanced Druid is not necessarily because they take the most damage, but because you can eliminate both Cyclone and damage-dealing attacks by pinning them down in bear form with tons of damage. So as a melee cleave, you do want to keep pressure on the Balanced Druid, so they have to at least somewhat consider defensive play, and they will not get to maximize their crowd control and damage.
So Super Tease, obviously you play the Moonkin. How do you get the most boom for your buck when you are playing this spec?
Well, Mauro here has a resource called Astral Power, which is that bar below his health, that blue one. As it builds up, he can spend that on a powerful attack called Star Surge. So if he can build that little blue bar all the way up, he can do two Star Surges. You want to combo that with Incarnation and crowd control on the enemy healer. So something like a Bash on Chaz and a Lightning Lasso on Raikou, Incarnation, double Star Surge, big damage,
big
huge
boom
for a kill in game number one. But outside of that window, you're not really much of a threat.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of sort of single target damage, or sorry, AoE damage with the dots that he has available, and that might end up costing Chaz a lot of mana later on, but at least initially, Swaps and Raikou can sort of heal themselves through that damage. Mauro's going to have to play a little bit defensive right now with Barkskin in bear form, and the longer he sits in bear form, that's really going to be limiting the amount of damage he can do, but he won't be taking that much damage either. Will ultimately, I think, this matchup come down to Chaz and Looney looking for drinks. Whoever can escape more, whatever team can keep the enemy druid in combat for long enough, will ultimately have the lead.
All right, Mauro setting up good crowd control on Chaz, but no damage to back it up, and no incarnation available to really overwhelm the opposing team. Mana is fairly even so far as we etch closer to dampening. No real significant lead. Both Chaz and Looney are mirroring their innervates, so perfect efficiency there on the Restoration Druids to maximize their mana output for a late game match. Mauro, he's got a bit of a Walrix cosplay going on there to survive that little bit of an attack, but now that Raikou is off of his back, he's going to be getting back into balance form, trying to get some damage out. We're really looking for Lightning Lasso. This Balanced Druid Elemental Shaman is all about one-hit wonders. Their sustained damage is relatively low outside of dampening, but when you can combine Star Surge and Lightning Lasso together, you can eradicate someone.
Definitely. Looney, I think, it was Chaz that actually went and sat down for a drink, so he was able to regenerate quite a bit of his mana by doing that, falling out of combat, drinking the water, and that replenishes his mana. Swapsy into a Lightning Lasso in midfield right now. Good pressure coming in from Zpy. It's going to be his Stormkeeper, but Swapsy responds with the anti-magic shell. That's going to be preventing a lot of magic damage for Swapsy. It's a relatively short cooldown, and one of the reasons why Death Knights are strong against casters. Cast of damage in particular.
On the team of Method Black, their defense, their rotational defense consists of Iron Bark for Chaz. He can use that onto any member of the team and reduce damage by a significant amount. Currently activating that, that's the glowing icon below his health. That is reducing damage on Swapsy. Perfectly timed here for Lightning Lasso. Now, if Swapsy is the target moving forward, we look below his health. That green icon with 27 seconds, that is anti-magic shield. Against a balanced druid and an elemental shaman, it effectively makes him immune to their damage. So Chaz and Swapsy need to rotate that Iron Bark and anti-magic shield. If they use them at the same time, that's a mistake. It will then create an opening for the opposing team to take him out later in the fight. Then, if we look at Raikou, we can see that middle icon, the blue middle icon at the top, that is Blur. That rotates effectively with Chaz's Iron Bark as well. But now here's an opening, 1 second away for that anti-magic shield. Luckily for Swapsy, it is now available, and he will start to stabilize. We get into dampening. That 1 second might not be enough for him to stay alive, so I'm not sold here. Wildcard Gaming might be able to pull this off.
Well, this is one of the main problems for the composition Wildcard Gaming has, is it's going to be pretty easy to keep Looney in combat. Swapsy has his pet, really good pet control on this match. You can see he's parked his pet on the pillar, so anytime Looney tries to escape, his pet will hit him. That ghoul that Swapsy has, Chaz also moving in, looking for some crowd control, and it's basically an inevitability at this point. If Method Black can just hold on, keep up the pressure, Chaz can sneak away for these drinks. Looney hasn't had that opportunity yet in this game. Already on 50% mana, 8% dampening. Things are going to be becoming increasingly more difficult for both of these teams. Morrow getting a little bit bursted down here, but should be completely fine as Raikou and Swapsy turn their attention onto Swapsy.
When you really theorycraft it for Wildcard Gaming, they can run double Thorns as double Druid, and with two melee attackers, Swapsy on Death Knight and Raikou on Demon Hunter, you would expect that to be very effective and almost countering their composition, but Death Strike, self-healing, and the leech healing of the Demon Hunter can more than easily just deny any damage that Thorns can actually output, which is why Method Black can just simply attack through it and ignore that mechanic. Method Black have crafted this composition to be one of the most ultimate dampener comps to extend the match and attrition their opponents. They've definitely theorycrafted a lot to make sure that they're bringing the most powerful option to this tournament in the current meta. Wildcard Gaming have tried to go to the drawing board and pull out this composition, and it could work, but it's going to take a lot of dampening. Looney's already behind on mana, and I don't know if they're going to be able to make it to that point.
And Method Black, this really shows the diversity in their roster. In the past, the core of that team was Raikou and Waz. They really focused on just Rogue Mage, but over the years, by bringing on Chaz, bringing on a player like Swapsy, it's given their roster so much more depth and diversity that they can bring in these cleave setups and play them at such a high level and basically have any comp that they need that's going to be good in the meta, they can play at a really high level. And Swapsy's always on the tournament realms, testing out new gear, trying to theorycraft which comps are going to be the best, and having someone like that on your team, sort of a mastermind, just gives you such an edge.
Good pressure here by Morrow's incarnation. That one was devastating. A little deeper into dampening, and Raikou doesn't make it out of that alive. He's actually cycloned at low health, pausing the incoming healing and damage and potentially opening some setup. There's no setup available, though, for Wildcard Gaming, and Raikou stays in the fight well and healthy. Now, Looney's mana is still looking decent moving into dampening, and I think with the one-hit wonder combo in another 3 minutes by both Morrow and Z-Pie, they can actually take Swapsy out. So Morrow just simply needs to survive for another 3 minutes, wait for that incarnation so he can boost his damage so it is powerful enough to kill either Raikou or Swapsy through their potent self-healing. Now Morrow is trying to stall the game by going into bear form, and as a balanced druid, that's a super effective way at just denying damage, especially by melee attackers. So good awareness on Morrow's part. We do see a bit of a setup here by Z-Pie, although interrupted by Raikou. Raikou moves over now towards Looney. Is he playing that Mana Rift talent? Doesn't appear to be the case. Looney jumping back to safety. Raikou switching targets, but caught in midfield. Morrow sets up crowd control, but Chaz already preempted it, activating that Iron Bark right before the crowd control hit. Nice premeditative move on his part. Now Morrow's on the back foot.
Yeah, I'm worried for Morrow in this matchup. If Raikou and Swapsy can maintain high uptime and 25% dampening and later, he might just have to sit and bear, and then maybe there's no hope for them to actually get counter pressure in this matchup. Chaz is moving in, looking for some crowd control on Looney. Mana Rift's going to be placed there by Raikou on Looney, and Looney's falling further and further behind in terms of mana. Morrow with the Thorns, feeling calm. confident to try to get some damage rolling. Gets interrupted on the cycle.
Oh.
Maybe forced into bear form once again. A full hex was snuck in by Zeepi. Nicely done. That might allow them to get some damage rolling, but Swapsky and Raikou, they're just keeping themselves up quite easily.
I mean, this is just costing all of Looney's mana to just keep Marv going in bear form. He can't get any counter pressure, just zero damage. Incarnation activated here. He needs to get some work done. There's the double Star Surge Lightning Lasso combo. Chaz denies the kill with Iron Bark. Morrow makes it annoying by cycloning it and denying its defense. Good job on Morrow's part, but really just not enough damage to push him over the edge. 26 seconds away from another big push for Morrow. And on that big push, I feel like they have to get a kill. I don't think Morrow's going to survive another 3 minutes after that. So Morrow needs to set up everything perfectly moving into that incarnation.
Yep, definitely. Triple Chaos Nova coming in. Nicely done. Imprisonment on Looney as well. Good pressure now onto Zeepi. He still has his Astral Shift. He might have to trade it out. At this point in dampening, it's good to just avoid damage. It's really difficult for the healer to recover. I mean, if you look, Chaz, he's sitting down for a drink. If he got full mana, he didn't. Luckily for Wildcard game, he only has about 50% mana. Looney's almost completely oom, but he's in stealth now. I think he's actually sitting down for a drink for the first time in this game. Chaz has to shut it down. Looney, how much mana did he get back? That's really going to be the most important thing. And actually is ahead of Chaz at this point. Really, Method Black dropping the ball there in the last few moments. At 36% dampening, that's when you really need to be paying attention, when Looney was completely out of mana.
Method Black are making really big mistakes. Chaz getting caught in hexes. Raikou used darkness, and then his whole team just ran out of the darkness's defense. Right now, Method Black are very sloppy, and it might cost them the game. Nice knockback on that anti-magic zone by Zeepi. Damage still rolling in as dampening ramps up to 38%. Chaz needs to line some big heals here up on the swap. See if he gets interrupted on that regrowth. Might be devastating. Doesn't seem to be available. Raikou getting cycloned. Mana has evened out. And Method Black's mistakes here in game one is an opportunity for Wildcard Gaming.
Yeah, Wildcard Gaming, they're ahead in terms of mana. Swapsy getting low, no anti-magic spell, no Icebound Fortitude, no nothing available for him. Chaz is going to have to keep him alive with a nice Iron Bark. Well-timed, but still pressure onto Raikou. Activates his Blur to avoid some damage. Incarnation now rolling for Morrow, looking to get aggressive. It's just a small incarnation due to the Azeroth traits. But Swapsy, in the meantime, a lot of pressure on him. Caught into the bash, and he could just fall right now. I don't know if Chaz has the healing. Gets wind sheared. Nicely done by Zeepi. Swapsy getting lower and lower in the matchup. For the first time, having to retreat behind the pillar. Zeepi chasing in, looking for a Stormkeeper. Swapsy with a nice interrupt will shut down that damage. Chaz might be able to keep him alive, but with no interrupt, Lightning Lasso onto Swapsy. Zeepi looking to close out this game, bash on Chaz, and I think that's it. Wildcard Gaming claiming game number one.
And there it is, the Moonkin going to be able to get work done this time. They're in it this year's season.
It'll definitely be interesting to see what Wildcard Gaming comes up with here. Like Super Tease was saying, Looney's going to be really good at healing through this damage, at least initially. A lot of damage over time effects coming in from both Waz and Swapsy, and with the counteract magic, the Renewing Mist does exceptional healing, and I think Zeepi and Blizzo should be very stable in this matchup.
Swapsy utilizing Hex defensively here, but Wildcard and Gaming have not completely committed their initial cooldown attack. They are trying to go after Looney as he exposes himself in center field to go for an all-in burst attack. Will it be enough to get the kill? No, Looney denies it. Now Waz on the back foot of this initial exchange. Looney keeps the crowd control chain going. They stun onto the trinket, desperately trying to take Waz down. He actually jumps out of bear form at a critical moment. Now Chaz is even further behind. Waz needs to get that Thorns used here shortly. Hopefully he doesn't make the same mistake that he made last week with not accessing that ability to boost his damage against these melee attackers.
I don't mind not using it there, as Looney had Way of the Crane up. It doesn't really get too much value, but I definitely agree. Now that that Way of the Crane is gone, Blizzo and Zeepi are going to be vulnerable to that Thorns, but Waz still sort of just getting trained down. Blizzo actually going after Swapsy. Looney's a little bit vulnerable here with no Life Cocoon for another 12 seconds. Use the Trinket during the last Lightning Lasso. Swapsy's basically playing this exactly how he should.
Okay.
Attacking the DPS isn't going to be great, but Swapsy, if he's running after Looney, constantly harassing him, he's going to be generating a lot more pressure for his team.
That is some smart usage of Thorns, using one on Waz and then one on Swapsy. So if you're playing Windwalker Death Knight, you can't not attack a target with Thorns and take that redirected damage. I think that is a good strategy for Method Black to maximize their damage. Decent pressure on Zeepi at this current moment, and we see mistakes on the side of Wildcard Gaming. They overlap their Life Cocoon here to try and keep Zeepi going, although now maybe it doesn't matter. They've got so much damage. Waz once again pinned back in bear form. Chaz repositions away from the fight. Chaz's main goal is to stay as far away from the action as possible, manage his mana deep into dampening, and avoid death as much as possible. We do see Blizzo going after Swapsy. Z-Pi splitting his pressure on Waz. This could be an effective strategy to run Chaz out of mana faster. Let's see how it plays out.
Yep, and one thing I noticed in this game is we often talk about Chaz and the rest of Druid and their innervates. Really important that they time that ability so they basically get free casted spells. They can use all their expensive healing to sort of top off their team. But Method Black, with this composition, they actually have Waz on a Moonkin, and they have Innervate as well. So that's a utility that the Moonkin has. He can help Chaz out with the Innervate as well. So Method Black has twice the moments in the game where Chaz can basically just free cast and try to top off. And he might need it in a situation like this. As Waz is getting lower, Chaz has to commit the Iron Bark. Bark skin already used by Waz. Z-Pi and Blizzo putting out a ton of pressure. Waz forced into bear form for so long. Swapsy has to look for some counter pressure here as he marches towards Looney, looking for a lightning lasso. But Looney so far in this matchup has been doing a pretty good job avoiding him. Chaz in cat form, looking for potentially a drink right now. Gonna make Z-Pi and Blizzo, although he's not actually sitting down for a drink, just the fact that he's in stealth is gonna freak out Wildcard Gaming.
Chaz not able to regenerate too much mana in that attempt, and this is why Wildcard Gaming went for the melee cleave on hook point that Method Black gave them. Maybe on a larger map, Method Black would have the advantage, but on the small playing field, Wildcard Gaming can turn that advantage in their own favor. Blizzo gets stunned up and bursted by Method Black. How are they gonna respond is the question. Diffuse magic is very effective against this composition, removing all damage over time effects and reducing magic damage significantly. Fair trade for Blizzo. Now it's time to get aggressive. Chaz is slowly but surely denying this damage with Iron Bark and now looking to sneak away for a drink to regenerate mana. Both Looney and Z-Pi see him in the corner and are able to stall it out despite Swapsy's efforts to assist. Chaz is not able to find that regeneration, and deeper into dampening, it's going to eventually cost them.
He definitely could. And thank you, Rich, for the sound effects. Touch of Karma is going to be used by Blizzo as he's making a push here onto Waz once again, trying to counter pressure this incarnation. Waz with the thorns, with the incarnation, is going to be able to put out quite a bit of damage. We look at mana. It's relatively even. There's not a big lead for either one of them right now. Chaz may be a little bit ahead, or it's almost exactly even. So really not going to be an advantage there. Chaz has been sneaking away looking for the drinks. So far, Wildcard Gaming has been able to shut it down. And I'm not actually sure, Sid, who do you think does have the advantage as we move forward to
If dampening? We get to 60% dampening and Chaz has mana, then Z-Pi dies. But if they can't get to 60% dampening with mana, then Wildcard Gaming are going to win. And I think that's basically as simple as the outcome as I can assess with the way that these compositions are faring so far. Wildcard and Gaming actually have a lot more momentum before dampening as well, which is bad news for Method Black because that's going to cost them a lot of mana to recover from.
Yeah, definitely. Chaz getting interrupted there. Swapsy getting lower. He traded out Trinket and Astral Shift in that last exchange. And he's not out of the woods yet. Chaz has to use the Iron Bark to keep him alive. Thorns tossed in by Waz. Waz with a great innervate there, allowing Chaz to basically free cast, get Swapsy's health popped off without really using too much mana. Looney in a good position, trying to just keep up the Renewing Mist, the Serpent Jade Statue. Every time he uses Soothing Mist on a target, a Serpent Jade Statue will also heal that target, and that's a lot of free healing that Wildcard Gaming has available, and I think it's one of the reasons why Mistweaver Monks are relatively mana efficient at healing is because of that statue.
I think something important to note is that Elemental Shamans and Balanced Druids both received nerfs to their mana regeneration as well, which is going to limit Healing Surge and limit Cyclone. Deeper into dampening, that could be critical for Wildcard Gaming to pull off a victory. They already have substantial momentum here in game number two. Method Black with strategical mistakes, and they're completely being exploited by Wildcard Gaming. They're gonna have to get their act together for the rest of the series if they want to stay in the upper bracket. Things are not looking good for them.
Yeah, definitely difficult. Swapsy still got a little bit low there. Chaz manages to top him off with the Iron Bark, but it's Chaz. He's sitting in stealth for long periods of time, trying to sneak away for these drinks or trying to just freak out Wildcard Gaming, one of the two, but he's just not able to actually sit down. Blizzo getting bursted down quite low. Not Lightning Lasso by Swapsy, but Swapsy's still the one that's in trouble, trying to cut away with Ghost Wolf. Blizzo feeling very healthy to charge in and get aggressive with this Touch of Karma activated. Leg Sweep now onto Chaz. Going to be denying incoming heals. Swapsy getting down low once again. Does have the Astral Shift if he chooses to use it. If Wildcard Gaming can get the Astral Shift here, that's going to be huge because Path of Death will be available. This is what I'm talking about. This is a lot of momentum for Wildcard Gaming. Blizzo, Touch of Death available. He has a Storm Earth and Fire. Right now, Wildcard Gaming, they can go for the all-in push. Looney needs to find some crowd control onto Chaz. Just a moment onto Swapsy where they can actually connect some damage, and I think they can close out the game.
Currently, Waz has Incarnation up. He has to be the playmaker. He's trying to save his team with a Cyclone, but gets denied by Z-Pi. Swapsy dips low. Huge damage deep into Dampening. Maledicts are soaking up the incoming heals. Chaz is struggling to recover, and this could be moving to match point, and it will. Wildcard Gaming punishing the mistakes of Method Black in game one. Completely
to pick. I think Wildcard Gaming has just been dealing a great hand so far.
And I think this is always kind of that secret weapon of Method Black, too. When they feel like they can move back to something, it is going to be that Rogue Mage. When you look at this team at the beginning of last year, you go, hey, look, they're one of the best Rogue Mage teams in the world, and then they don't even need to play it. Waz just jams the Pirate the entire time and sails to victory. But now let's see what they can do.
Yep. It looks like Method Black, they're looking to ante up in this series, looking for some damage early on Morrow. Combustion does get used by Raikou, so this is good initial aggression by Method Black. Looney using the Bark Skin as well on himself. And sort of a split strategy is coming in. Waz is just deleting Looney. What is happening right now? He's just trapped in this room. Another
Greater Pyro
is going to be used. Greater Pyro Blast does connect, doesn't do too much damage. Looney with the damage reduction ultimately will survive, but that's a great start for Method Black.
You can tell that Zico and Elliot are happy to see Greater Pyro Blast here in game number three, as they've been having a real blast with it at home. Multiple Greater Pyro Blasts being casted out here by Raikou and a Cyclone now at respectively low health. I do think compositionally the Rogue Mage does do well into this. There's not enough disruption. Raikou just freely cast Greater Pyro Blast. I would like to see the team Wildcard Gaming reposition so Raikou could not just stand in one place channeling these over and over.
Venruki, I've had the pleasure of being your friend for a long time. I watched you as a competitor before that. There are not many times I've seen you have like a true smile and just be this happy.
Really? Am I that much of a grump?
Usually when I'm talking, you are. Every time you see a Greater Pyroblast casted, it is the purest joy I think we've ever seen. What is it about Greater Pyroblast that makes you enjoy it so much, seeing these big, giant G-Pies coming through?
Well, it's a casted spell, and it feels rewarding for getting it off. I mean, you channel it out for 4 seconds. If you do manage to get that cast off, you know something's going to happen. And it's one of those spells in the game right now that just can create windows of opportunity out of nowhere, whereas Frostbolt, it's going to be a little bit less damage when you cast it on someone. You know really not too much is going to happen, though with the Greater Power Blast, you're constantly finding these moments of burst.
Good crowd control initiation here by Method Black over towards Z-Pi, but Raikou unable to get any gigantic Greater Pyro Blast off in this position. Now that Wildcard Gaming have moved their butts around on the map, although Morrow is just staying in midfield, I'm not really sure how he hasn't been punished for that with Raikou constantly casting these Greater Pyro Blasts. I do think that that's going to be a weakness that Method Black can exploit moving forward, and Morrow needs to be much more aware.
Yeah, definitely. Morrow's going to be interrupting that cast, and that's really what it's going to come down to for Wildcard Gaming. They need to slow down Raikou in this matchup, and it is a stall game for them. Looney not doing too great on mana. I don't know if Chaz has managed to sit down in this fight just yet. Now quite far away, Looney's going to be chasing him, and I'm actually curious to see which one of these druids has more mana. At this point, it's relatively even. Actually, Looney a little bit behind. Raikou getting a lot of burst damage off. And that's the thing, if Raikou can free cast these Greater Pyroblasts, Looney, that is so much mana he has to use to heal up through that damage, especially with Waz on the Assassination Rogue having that healing reduction. Z-Pi trying to get some counter pressure here onto Raikou, but Raikou's been having a field day on this Fire Mage so far.
Pressure back and forth. Greater Pyroblast gets interrupted by Z-Pi. Good denial. Morrow looking to strike back with this Incarnation activated, boosting his damage. This next Star Surge could hit hard. Not able to find it, holding on to it for now, waiting for crowd control on Chaz, looking to line up first together. Morrow is just soaking all of these Greater Pyro Blasts in midfield, and eventually this is going to get punished. I do not think that he can continue taking this fire from Raikou. Waz getting counter-pressured away by Z-Pi as he tries to carry the team on his back. They're on match point. Is Wildcard Gaming going to be able to knock Method Black to the lower bracket 3-0? They've got a significant mana lead in this position, and they're looking strong.
Yep, Chaz with the Innervate trying to keep his team alive. Incarnation available for Morrow is going to be able to get very aggressive at some point. Smoke Bomb does get dropped out, but Raikou Haku not able to get the Ring of Frost onto Looney, and unfortunately without that crowd control, really not too much damage is going to be happening. Zipa with a nice interrupt here. And I think Wildcard Gaming at the beginning of the game, they really weren't handling the Greater Power Blast well at all, but now they've been doing a much better job to slow down Raikou. Chaz sitting down for a drink. Looney's trying to chase him. He manages to find the Vortex. And I like wasting Chaz's time. He sits down for 3-4 seconds, hasn't regenerated any mana yet, but during those 3 or 4 seconds, he hasn't been able to heal up his team, and that's an opportunity for Wildcard Gaming to start getting some damage, some pressure, so denying the heals, but waiting a little bit so Chaz wastes his time is a good strategy from Wildcard
Gaming. Trying to focus in on how Method Black can find victory. They just made a swap to Looney, and they got his Bark Skin. So if they make another swap and catch him out of bear form, they can get his Glider's Medallion, which he would normally like to use during Blind. So I think Method Black are going to look for that opportunity. Currently going after Morrow. They definitely need to do it soon. They've only got 30 more seconds until Barkskin is available for Looney. Looney's just playing max range away while his team rains down Devastation. Raikou moves over to try and find him, doesn't find him, and Looney's likely resetting back to a full mana bar. We'll have to wait and see here as he comes out of stealth. Definitely significantly far ahead, moving into dampening over Chaz. We see a Maledict attack here towards Raikou. Nice Lightning Lasso, although getting a bit of a miscommunication that you do not want to immune the Lightning Lasso damage. It's the hardest hitting spell on the team of Wildcard Gaming. A little bit of a miscommunication, a misfiring by that Cyclone of Morrow. Although the pressure is just mounting itself. If Chaz can't regenerate mana, eventually the damage output of Wildcard Gaming could overwhelm them, and this isn't looking good for Method Black. I've not seen Wildcard Gaming have such a good showing against Method Black in any tournament prior. This is a good start to the tournament season for Wildcard Gaming.
Yeah, definitely can't count them out. You know, one thing Method Black does have going for them in this match is how much single target damage they have and the healing reduction from Waz. So that's going to be basically accelerating dampening by 25% for Waz. Chaz almost completely tapped on mana. If Raikou and Waz can find a nice push on, I'm not sure who, if it should be Zipai or Morrow, I would assume Zipai in this matchup. Normally Rogue Mage, they like to go after the Elemental Shamans, but he still has his trinket, he still has his Astral Shift, he's going to be tanky. Looney almost has the Iron Bark, Chaz pushing in for some crowd control, finds the Bash Cyclone on Looney, but every time he goes for those Cyclones, it's going to be using quite a bit of his mana, but I feel like Method Black, they have to take those risks in this matchup if they want to win. They managed to get the Fire Blood Racial from Zipai, so he won't have that available during Vendetta, which is a big win. Raikou finds one Greater Fire Blast onto Morrow, but I think Looney should be able to easily heal through that damage as all three members of Wildcard Gaming push in, looking to really pressure down Chaz, forcing him off the pillar and to run away. But they need to chase. They can't allow Chaz to get away behind the pillar by himself, and Looney, realizing this, pushes in. This is another thing I've noticed from Looney in this game. Every single time Raikou gets his Dragon's Breath, he's in cat form or bear form, so the only option Raikou really has is to get the Ring of Frost, which makes it much easier for Zipai to deny any sort of follow-up poly or just interrupt the Ring of Frost if he can. So very important for the rest of the Druids playing at home. If a mage is harassing with Dragon's Breath Sheep, you want to be in bear form, so they only really have that option with Ring of Frost, and your team can help you out a lot easier.
Both teams in Game 3 are playing a round of Run Kitty Run as these Druids need to sneak away and get drinks to regenerate their mana for a late-stage dampening kill, but at this point, Wildcard Gaming are overwhelming Method Black and suppressing any opportunities that go their way. Waz finally pulling the trigger on Vendetta and having to run away with it. Now getting cycloned up, that damage is completely denied. Raikou's left alone in midfield. Huge attack by Wildcard Gaming as Chaz has basically nothing to recover. Likely an ice block. Capacitor Totem sniped out Chaz. Raikou's desperate. Ring of Frost defensively onto the Palantir. Looney jumps over to Dispel to get Morrow back into the fight as soon as possible. Chaz crosses the map. Looney, Morrow, and Zipai need to be in hot pursuit to deny this mana regeneration. Chaz sits down.
Waz
starting to get some sips, but Waz got left behind. He's getting bursted. No Cloak of Shadows. Manages to vanish away from the fight, but even that may not be enough, and Chaz is completely strangled out on mana. He's got nothing left in the tank to keep this fight going. Looney still has a bit more moving forward, and they need a miracle. Method Black absolutely need a miracle to come back in this.
Yeah, looking for a Greater Power Blast, unfortunately not finding it. Raikou still has this Combust. If they can pull out the Astral Shift before Combustion, that's a window for Method Black to actually close out the game. But right now, Method Black, they have nothing going for them. Wildcard Gaming, to their credit, they have played out this series beautifully. Every single one of these maps, all these comp picks, perfectly crafted into Method Black. Raikou looking for a Combustion kill right now with good pressure onto Zipai, but not even forcing out the Astral Shift. Zipai is going to be completely fine unless his Greater Power Blast goes off. Morrow interrupts it with the Solar Beam, and that's the thing about the spell is during the early stages of the game, you can sit there, free cast, tank a lot of damage, but later on, if you're in midfield for 12 seconds looking for greater power blast, this is what happens. You get stuck, and Morrow and Zeepi can force out that ice block. Now Raikou doesn't really have too much left in terms of defense.
I mean, at this point, there's no windows. Raikou is just stranded in the middle of the map. That's not where you want to be against Wildcard Gaming. Even one more hit could just take him down, knock him to the lower bracket. Lightning Lasso turning this match into a rodeo. Cyclone secured onto Chaz. Raikou is still alone. Iron Bark is the only thing stabilizing him, but even still struggling to top off, manages to get at least to a healthy margin of health. There's a smoke bomb, there's a Vendetta. Zeepi does not have a Gladiator's Medallion. There's an opportunity for miracles here if Waz can be the miracle maker. Can he do it in time? Raikou's got nothing.
Maledict onto the Fire Mage's Cauterize. Such a counter there from Wildcard Gaming. Beautifully done, nice setup, well executed by Wildcard Gaming.
Feed versus the fake Zebras, we're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.